But he deposited the key, he put him in this room, left my horse in the bed. And after an hour or so, he looked down at his neck, little kid, and he's complaining, I want this over here, I don't want that, I want this. I don't want this, I want that. Father knew that this kid was never gonna amount to anything, and nothing ever makes him happy. But he looks in this closet where the kid's closet, the kid has a shovel, he's shoving this horse over his shoulder, he's laughing, singing, and having a good time. First thing the father thinks, this kid is crazy. But he asked his son, what's going on? What's going on? The little boy looked at his dad and said, you know, Dad, as much harsh on her as there is in this room, must be a pony at the bottom of it. The reason I tell you that is when people introduce me and talk about all the things that I've done and all those things, but they don't talk about the crap that I was in. They got me nuts. So I'm thinking he's like one of these voodoo guys. So I'm just sitting there thinking about what he's talking about. And he said, I'll tell you what I want you to do. I want you to go back, because I write a lot. I write everything. So I want you to go back and look at some of your writings from a couple of years ago, comparing to a couple of months ago to today. As I was going back looking at my writing, I could see what was happening to me. I started noticing the anger that I had as a little boy growing up. The kids that were making fun of me. And that's the reason I became that Superman that broke out. That they were not going to hurt me anymore. That when I got to Georgia, Frank saved my life, because even though he said there was people going to make fun of me, that no one was going to hurt you, and they wouldn't have hurt me because I would have hurt someone. They didn't realize that God had been taking care of me. That when I got to Georgia, when I got to pro football, what was funny is all the guys that was just jealous because all of a sudden now this young kid coming in making all this money but didn't like me. It didn't matter to me. As long as they didn't step in my little yard, I was okay. But God didn't help me, so I can see it in my writing, that anger. So I decided, you know what, I need to go get help. That's why I tell him, Jerry, I need to go to a place, I want to go to a hospital. And I went out to California to this hospital to do some work. We all suffer. We all fall short of the glory of God. Our problem is we're too prideful to admit it. So at that time I decided I better start really working. I better admit to what I have faith. You got to work at it. And I said, there's no shame in my being. Because let me tell you, I was miserable. Didn't even know. I couldn't even see the light. And I thought everything was going well. I was miserable. You got to have faith. That we go through so many different things in our life. Go through so many different things. And no matter what we're going through, as Jesus that died and came back, and he said, I said, get up. I don't think he called us a bomb. But he just said, get up. He said, it ain't over. He said, get up. And let's go again. Because, you know, as I was seeking to get help, you know, when I first told everyone I had this social identity disorder, everybody, a lot of my friends put up the cross like I was a vampire. They started running away from me like rats on a ship, a sinking ship. They started saying, oh, geez, Herschel's nuts, Herschel's crazy. And I said, that's all right, because I knew myself. And now, all those people are coming back. All of them coming back because they're right, that we're all suffering. That we're all hurting. The thing is, who won't admit that you're hurting? Who won't admit that you've got a problem? Because there's no shame in my game. You know, you don't have to be a Superman. All you gotta do is be yourself. You gotta just love yourself. And that's all I do is love myself. Because, you know, I'm stronger today than I've ever been. I'm better today than I've ever been. I smile today. You know, before I didn't have all ever smiled. And I didn't even know that.